Welcome to episode 34 of the adventures of Chili the Doombringer and the tales of Maj'Eyal. I think we're gonna continue our Urh'Rok Pride quest. And, I don't know, Rak'shor? I think maybe we can try out those. Rak'shor or Vor Pride. First, let's go back in here and just change our equipment back. So we don't need the... sticking to this one. I don't know, this one is just so nice with the physical resistance, constitution, physical save reduces opponent's crit chance by 20%. That's all good stuff, so I don't know, we should be able to find something better soon. Okay, what else did we... Let's see, amulets... I was using something... like... this one... yeah... And, there's our new gloves... these are cool. These are also very nice. I think overall these are a bit better, so... no constitution there. Oh, the ring. Yeah, we equip the ring of speed. What do we want? This one, right? Yeah. Let's just rest up. I think we're gonna have to fight some orcs out here. Right about those guys. Saving. Yeah, sure. Fight. What are you? Berserkers. Pyromancer, fighter, warrior. What do we do? Let's to try the Rak'shor Pride, or the Vor Pride, or the Grushnak. Let's have a look at the Rak'shor Pride in the west. Here's the Rak'shor Pride Bastion. So, what do we get here? Ooh. Hello. Okay, we found a scale mail of Kroltar, a heavy shirt of scale mail constructed from the remains of Kroltar, whose armor was like tenfold shields. Okay, maybe we have found the new armor we have been waiting for. Okay, wolf. Oozing horror. Valkyra, the Auric Necromancer. Okay. These guys are Blood Mages, Necromancers, and Corruptors. Okay, they can be pretty rough. She's a Sandrake. These Necromancers and Blood Mage. Well, I guess we're gonna just try the same tactics or strategy that worked well against or in the Gorbat Pride, so we jump down there and get rid of. We have this Rigor Mortis. 26% more damage from necrotic minions. Oh well. Oh, this guy can make these Forgery of Haze things. Okay. Holy Lord! That was a lot of lightning damage. Let's do this and this. Our Vim is totally almost drained. Yeah, we're gonna have to be a bit careful in here, it seems. I underestimated those guys a bit. Apart from that, the strategy was okay. Oh Lord. Ruined Bone Giant. Towering creature made from the bones of hundreds of dead bodies, ruined etched and infused with hateful sorceries. Okay. Now. Someone have a bone shield. I can. Yeah, it can reassemble, so. It's okay, let's do that. No. Bone horror. Necromancer somewhere. Why are we disarmed? Dude. Okay. Yeah, necromancers are a pain. Shields Maiden. Myths tell of Shields Maidens, a tribe of warrior women from the northern wastes of Maj'Eyal. The marsh prose muted with infestation of swaths of admirers at all unrequited. So begin saying that a Shields Maiden's heart is as cold and unbreakable as her shield. Aw. Too bad we're not using shields. Get that cool shield, by the way. found that scale mail lore of whatever. Huh. Well, anything we want here, though. Necromancers, those need special treatment, so to speak. Okay, Necromancer, bang, oh, yeah, I probably should have waited with... Shouldn't have opened the door right away. Okay. Answers. Let's see now. Let's actually use our speed and answers. That's it. It's strange we found the lore for that scale mail thingy and we didn't find the scale mail itself. Oh well. Anything we could want here? No. Cloak. Shadow Elven Silk Cloak of Implacability. This is cool. Let's move on. Okay, sort of different layout. Nice. Let's for a moment switch back to like Satin's ultimatum. Two. this sanguine horror. Abomination. This black fire Aegis stone shield, cool, but not really, not for Chili. So we seem to do around 440-ish damage on average on a normal hit with this, so let's pay some attention to how we do with that Laya fine thingy. 335, 800, 400, 800, it's critical. Has been turned off. There we go. Oops. Ow. Yeah, that seems to be it for the second level, isn't it, of Rak'shor Pride 2. And who keeps disabling all our stuff? Should be some kind of disrupting effect somewhere. Oh well, loot, willpower. Star, bow. Coolish cloak. But yeah. Well, the damage reduction. Nice. So it's healing though. Physical save. I don't know. Cool shield. Yeah. Nope. Let's just continue here. Final, the final level of the, whoa, Rak'shor Pride. Let's rest. Rak'shor, the Grand Necromancer. Lots of bone giants here. Okay. This can be a tough fight, so. I know, let's pull back a little bit. Hey, level 42! Yay! Meaning of life. No. Answer to the question we don't know. And we had a new prodigy, of course. Which I'm really excited about. Let's do this. Now we go for Rak'shor. New heroism, destroyer. Draining assault. Oh, stuff is. Okay, let's get this back on. And we got him. Okay. It's not as tough as I feared. Let's see. We got Dawn's Blade, Longsword, an Orb of Undeath. It's an Orb of Command. Dark visions fill your mind as you lift the orb. It's cold to the touch. Rak'shor has also got a note. The eyes of the dead bring interesting news to me. Our masters are not what they appear. They're human, simply masquerading as orcs in our presence. I might have suspected this. It is difficult to disguise the basic weakness and frailty of a human soul, even with complex spells. Your goals elude me, as in strange energies in the vicinity of the high peak. Voices of spirits long departed from this world, some not from this world at all. Oh, but this foolishness compared to my current trials. Yeah, Gorbat remains as obstinate as ever. Dragon-loving, scale-shining buffoon. He thinks that dragons are special, different, not suitable for my craft. I care not for his prattling. These are the corpses of dragons. Corpses of dragons, yeah. Mountains of them. How can his heart not beat a little faster at the prospect of a Draco zombie? The mere thought of it is enough to send delightful shivers down my spine. Yeah, let's just say I'm not a voice artist of any kind, but well, it's fun to try. sorry if that was stupid. Or whatever you thought. It's okay. Let's finish up this level, which we seem to have done. Yep. Loot. What? No. This one should be on 8. Yes. If you don't know, you can press F1 to see weapons, F2 for armor, F3 for this, and useful. And then another shortcut is to F8, the transmo chest. So, cool longsword, we don't want it. Blah blah blah, Star of Longbow Shot, Digger, Blood Hexed. Plus 9 strength, 6 willpower. Well, I'm sorry. Strength. Oh, 139, yeah. Is that enough? I think so. Yeah, what do we level up? We are level 42, and that means... nope. We get another prodigy. Haha. So, well, we can spend our points here first, I guess. Get more dexterity. I'm gonna get more... Well, do we really need to get it that much? Does 46 damage. Get it up to 59. 47. 12. That I might be happy with only 3 levels here, actually. So let's get this one now. Pretty cool thing. The trance, you summon have a global resistance equal to your blight resistance. What's my blight resistance at the moment? It's 19%. Cool. But what I'm gonna do now is I'll just pause the recording and decide what prodigy to choose, and I'll get back to you. Alright, I think I've reached a conclusion here. While this one does seem really, really cool, we don't really need more offensive capabilities now, do we? Of course, it wouldn't hurt. Such a doubt, but the other one I'm really heavily considering is this one. Improves life or hit points by 250, defense by 23, saves by 23, armor hardiness. Well, our hardiness is currently at 100%, so but okay, and it will improve with constitution, so at least the saves and defense. I think that's the best thing of what we can get. There are some others we could at least theoretically unlock if we get like cunning to 50 or stuff like that. This one's also nice, Spine of the World. Yeah. I don't know, I think I'll go for this one, even though this one seems cool. Well, this one too. Well, of course, this is good. It's so hard to choose. Well, let's get this one. I think it's the best. We have, or well, yeah, it's best for us right now. Yeah, all right, we do that. There we go. Now for the class point, what did I want there? Should get more Fearscape, and we should get more down here. Or should we put some points? Alright, I'll just put 1 point into Fearscape. And yeah. So, that's level 42. And the Rak'shor Pride. Done. Yes. So, I think that's enough for now. We're at about half an hour, so. And we did some really nice progress. Yeah. Next time we'll go to, I don't know, the War Pride maybe. Or, yeah, with War Grushnak. We'll see. Probably War Pride, I guess. It's a good idea. So, thank you all for watching, and join me again next time.